Welcome to Bar Meals, Maine. After a 90 degree scorching weekend, it's now 68 foggy degrees right here in Maine. We have more answers to more questions and get neck deep into the production of our new HO scale water tower at Cranberry Yard. Yes, it's Monday morning at the station. Here I stand, coffee in hand, and I want to welcome you to Bar Meals on this humid, sticky Monday morning in the month of June. Welcome to our shop. Now, I know you all know what our shop looks like, and you're not thinking that this is our shop. What you're thinking about is the station where we do all of our production. But this here behind me is our shop, and our shop is where we keep our woodworking equipment, things that help us make shelves, and more shelves and displays and more displays are all done right here. And as of recently, with videos such as the one you're looking at right now, this is also the area where the more current videos are photographed. So let's take a look as we head inside the shop at Bar Meals. Welcome to the shop at Bar Meals, and I say shop and not the station because this is the area that we make all of our displays and more displays and shelves and more shelves and all kinds of things that you may have seen us use when we travel around and do model railroad shows. It's this area here that gives us a lot of flexibility and gives us not only greater production, but an additional space to develop new concepts, both in kits and of course, on my own personal level, for making anything from cutting boards to little turn bowls and so on for my own personal family life. Let's take a look at what's going on right now at Bar Meals, and we're going to be introducing a new kit today in HO scale. Before we even get into this part of the video, we just want to mention that we've had massive delays in shipping by both the post office and especially UPS. Our local shift supervisor over here in United Parcel in Portland, Maine, has told us that they had trucks sitting on premises with as many as 18,000 undelivered packages at any given time because they are so backed up by Amazon. So Amazon, this whole thing, as great as it seems to be, is really screwing up with UPS and causing all kinds of delays. And in case you're not aware, UPS also handles a great deal of the mail that we send out here. So everything is impacted. This COVID thing is what it is. But the big thing is Amazon has made out big time and has been flooding UPS with packages, and it's impacted all of us. So if you don't get a package on time or even intact, which we've had some reports of, do not take it personally. It's just the way the system has been operating since this whole COVID scare started. And now just a quick response. A fellow named John McLeod of Virginia wanted to know when the water tower at Cranberry Yard will be available and what are the dimensions. Well, you know what, John? This is the greatest way to answer this question. This is the water tower at Cranberry Yard. I'll hold this closer to the camera. Now this, to be honest, is version 2 because it's coming in two separate flavors, you might say. One will be simply the tower without the side shed, and one will be what we call the combo, which is the tower and the side shed. Now, judging from what we've seen and heard from other friends who are modelers, they tend to want more than one of these towers. So we may put together a combo pack. We'll see how that works out. But the tower at Cranberry Yard is actually in production right now and will be posted on the Bar Meals website for those of you who want to make sure to get into this early. A few things about the model, and you can see the pictures up on the screen here. The tower itself is an easy build. Traditionally, it would take a lot of work to do something cylindrical and do all the boards, and especially with the domed roof with the shake shingles. But in this case, the bottom of the tower, the stone piece is a one-piece resin casting, including the door that's built into it. The tower itself, the cylindrical water tank part of the tower, is also a one-piece casting that was handmade by Jack Ellis. And the very top, the dome, is actually two pieces. It's the dome with all of the shingles already installed and just requiring some painting and weathering, as well as a finial, which simply gets screwed in and plugged into the top of the of the roof to complete the look of the assembly. The only thing that kind of hangs out and makes a little bit different is there is some wood bracing that holds the spout on the front of the building. The spout itself is made of plastic, and we got that from Grantline, so you know it's going to be high quality. So that's going to be a standalone item. And then if you look up here again at the screen, you'll see the version 2. Now version 2, instead of being 1.5 by 1.5, which is what the tower is essentially, not including the spout extension, the second version is also 1.5, but goes to about 5 to 5.5 inches in length because of that service facility that is attached to it. And of course, the service facility is all laser cut. Jim Mooney worked really hard to come up with a concept that Jack and I hadn't even dreamed of coming up with. And he developed a really cool building with a very cool look. And you'll be able to see the photos far better than you could see the actual model here. This is why we do it and present it in two different ways. The pricing and the availability will be on the website. We are going into production this week, so they will not be shipping today or tomorrow, but hopefully in the next few days, one version or the other will start leaving the shop here at Barr Mills. We suggest you take a look at both versions. Chances are, if you have any size layout, this is not a huge water tower. It's really set up for branch line, narrow gauge, small town locations. Chances are you'll probably want to get at least one, if not more, of these around your railroad. So this is called the Tower at Cranberry Yard and is yet another kit in the series. We are actually working on the Sandhouse at Cranberry Yard next. So if you're familiar with the Cranberry Yard series, we have the Yard Office at Cranberry Yard, the Freight House at Cranberry Yard, the Station at Cranberry Yard, the Water Tower now, and next up will be the Sandhouse at Cranberry Yard. So here again, we have to give a lot of credit to both Jack Ellis, who built this prototype, as well as Jim Mooney for all of his incredible engineering, and you'll see that reflected in the instructions. Next time around, in 2 weeks, because now Monday morning at the station is bi-weekly for the summer, we'll be featuring a new kit in N-scale. So we hope you all stay tuned. And by the way, here again, this is the shop and our new digs as far as the videos go. We hope you enjoy the videos, and we hope you share the hobby with others, and we hope you all stay well. We appreciate your support. It's been overwhelming, and honestly, we're having trouble keeping up with it, but I tell you what, keep it coming. We love it. Thank you so much. This is Artie on behalf of Jim, Jack, Lenny, Nancy, and the rest of the crew at Barr Mills, wishing you a healthy and happy and very safe summer. So good to me. Monday morning.